Oh, bless your name, Jesus. God is so good. And his mercy is just clarified. And we just thank God for what he's doing right here in New Vision. And if this is your first time here, listen, just get with us, because we're worshipers. We love God. We worship. Oh, yes, we worship you. And as we get ready to read the word is going to be in Luke, the second chapter. We will be coming from the New King James Version. And as you are preparing, and it will come up on the screen momentarily, we, me and Pastor, have been doing this series, Hope for the Holidays. Hope for the Holidays. Have you enjoyed it? Has it done something for you? She says, you can enjoy it, but has it done something for you? Have you taken in the word and all that God has given? So I'm going to ask you to stand on your feet as we get ready to read the word. And I'll be reading from Luke, the second chapter, beginning from the first verse, going down to the 14th. Oh, bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. And I see they have the King James Version out, so that's great. Okay, that's good. And you can read from your screen if you don't have the Bible. And it says, and it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that when they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And what it means is she was ready to give birth. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. And the word of the Lord is blessed. You may be seated. Amen. This is the time of the year that we celebrate Christmas. This is the time of the year when so many things are going on. And this is the time of the year when so many don't necessarily have hope. But there is hope in the Lord. And today my subject is, and it was so evident in the service, after all the series, after all the preaching, after even last week where Pastor preached on hope among the thorns, I need to let you know that hope is here. Somebody say, hope is here. When I begin to think about the season and how, unfortunately, there are many who don't really celebrate the Christ in Christmas. There's many that basically begin to celebrate the holiday as it is secular and commercialized. And what begins to happen right at Thanksgiving and then right the day after, we have what's called what? Black Friday. We have the Black Friday sales, and then on Monday we have the Cyber Monday specials, all in preparation for buying gifts for family and friends. And it's that time when the family will get together. Some will travel, some will come from wherever they may be, but you go to see your loved ones. And it's the hope that you hope that they have not forgotten you, that someone in due time will give you a gift, even if you can't use it. You ever got one of those that? You get that gift and you're like, oh, thank you so much. And you're like, oh, do you want to do this? But they say it's the thought that counts, right? It is the thought that counts. My brother said they didn't think hard enough. But it's still the thought that counts. This is the time of year when so many of you wish that you could skip the holiday. When you could really wish that if I could just skip from the day after Thanksgiving and just get to the new year, because it's a hard time of the year. Maybe because of the memories that come because of the loss of loved ones, or maybe because of the loss of just things. There was a time when you had it because of how things are now, because of the recession that hit in 2008, you still haven't been able to quite get yourself together. Maybe because of the loss of what used to be, or maybe just because the loss of love. You know, I was thinking as I was preparing for this message, some of you may remember this song by John Lennon and Paul McCartney, and it said, "Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though it's here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday." Some of your loved ones probably don't know that now, but suddenly I'm not the man or woman that I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. And I'm here to say to you today that yesterday might have been yesterday. But it comes a time that you have to get out of yesterday. Y'all know, we, those of us that have matured and getting a little older, remember how we were either in sports and could do certain things, how we could exercise and really do those great things we used to do, how we could run, or maybe you couldn't run, really walk fast, and as you mature, there's just certain things that you could do yesterday that maybe you can't do today. And you're working hard to maybe get to what yesterday. But I told a friend of mine once, I'm like, you trying to be in yesterday, but your mind is saying 20 or 25, but your body is saying 55 or 65. You just can't do what you did yesterday. And there are those things in the past that we need to realize that we have hoped for and we want to be and we used to be, but we've got to get out of the past. And as one of the messages that was preached, we're trending now. What's trending now? What's happening now? What's going on now? You need to acknowledge where you are today. And one thing I began to realize is that many people are so stuck in yesterday that you're not honest with yourself on where you are today. In your mind, you're trying to be what you used to be. But it's time to get beyond that and be in today and just be honest with yourself. Where are you today? What are you doing today that you need to correct? What are you doing today that you need to fix? What are you doing today that you may have knowledge of, but you just can't get past the point of that you need to do it? Well, I need to tell you that hope is here. And then that you can't get out of being stuck.
Yes.
And even though you may think you know it all, but I'm going to tell you, you really don't know it all. He says, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this is one thing I do know. I'm reaching forth unto those things which are before me. And I press towards the mark. I press towards the mark. I press towards the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. You see, it's one thing to hope. It's one thing to want to hope. But it's another thing to have hope. You hear what I'm saying? You may want to hope and you may want to have it, but when you do have hope, something inside of you will trigger. Something inside of you will know what to do. So where are we at now? We're in that time of year where we have Jesus. And Jesus is about to be born. We find that Joseph and Mary, as they were coming from Nazareth, and they were going to be registered. We find that they were on their way to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. And in the city of David, they find that as they were about to register and take care of business, all of a sudden Mary felt that, oh my God, I'm in full term. I'm about to have this baby. And as she was about to have the baby Jesus, there was no room in the end. There was no room for her to have her child. No hotels, no places, no individuals that she could go to so she could have her child. Here they are now in the city of David, in the city. And there was no room for her to have a child. And when I begin to think how many in our lives, how many times, there's no room for you right here. There's no room many times when you think in terms of this time of the season, you're thinking in terms, there's no room for me. But what do you mean, Reverend Rose said, there's no place for me? Why? Because maybe you're in a situation that you've been kicked out. Maybe you're in a situation that occurred and now there is no family. And you feel as though there's no hope. So where do you go and where do you place yourself? And what do you do when you have no place to go? What do you do when you have no place even to put your clothes on? When you go to the shelter and there's no room in the shelter, where do you go? What place do you go to? When it seems like all hope is gone, what happens? When it seems like you don't fit in. Anyone ever feel like you just don't fit in? Like you just don't fit in. Well, I tried to do this, but I'm so out of the box. It just seems like I just don't fit in. My creative spot is working and nobody quite understands quite who I am. And there's just no room. There's no room that can be a place. No room because you're in despair. No room. Why? Because of the stress. It seems as though there's no hope. But let me tell you that if you just hold on long enough, Christ is about to be born.